Man, what are they teaching people in school these days? Today we're going to be discussing why you need to worry about the laws of physics when you're inventing your products. In one of my recent videos, I had posted about a free energy device that you can build at home. Now, of course, this was clickbait because there's no such thing as free energy. If we remember, the law of conservation of energy says that matter can neither be created nor destroyed. Basically, you don't get any free energy. If you like what you've been hearing so far, please be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, give me a thumbs up, and leave some comments below. I love to answer your questions. But of course, there are people on YouTube that keep posting videos about free energy devices and how they have a perpetual motion machine, but we all know that these things are all fake. I'm originally from Philadelphia, so that would explain the way I act. They have motors in them, there's a battery hidden in a device, they're using magnets off screen. I've even seen videos debunked where they use a fan to blow air on the object and make it spin. The one that you can see here that I'm talking about is a device that supposedly uses one motor with magnets to drive another motor continuously. Do you really think that that free energy device will keep spinning forever and ever? The only thing those magnets are doing is acting as a gear, but most people aren't even smart enough to understand that when looking at it. Now, if you believe the device in that video really works, I have a bridge to sell you. What you have in the center is a flywheel. The flywheel is a heavy mass that is storing the energy and keeping the device spinning. Yes, there's a capacitor there. That's the trick, because everybody thinks the capacitor is what's doing it. Not only is the energy in the capacitor immediately depleted, it's also balanced in that generator motor circuit there. So the one motor is supposedly generating electricity while the other one is using it. And somehow it's magically supposed to produce more energy than it's producing. How that happens, I have no idea. Here's a warning for you. I'm really not that smart, so don't believe everything I say. Do your own research and learn the laws of physics. But really what you're looking at is a short video with a flywheel. Personally, I never stop learning. Even doing these videos and teaching you guys helps me learn and remember what I was taught a long time ago. And if you know anything about mass and going back to that law of conservation of energy, objects that are in motion also want to stay in motion. So if we don't apply any friction or force to that flywheel, in theory, it would spin forever. But unfortunately, it has to overcome something called gravity. Because if you look at the comments below in the video, you'll see that I mentioned the word gravity that was the main cause of why that flywheel was going to stop, and someone questioned me. The joke is probably on me. If you go back to that free energy device video again, you'll see that right before he disconnects the power supply, there's a cut. It's very likely he has two wires hidden under the table there, and that's what's making the motor spin. Because in order to keep that flywheel spinning, we need a bearing of some sort. Even if we use an air bearing, there's still going to be some sort of friction that is caused in that spinning axis. Now, we overcome the friction with the bearing, but you still have some, and that's the loss of energy that starts to accumulate with the flywheel. I really do sound like a nerd sometimes. So eventually what happens, that flywheel comes at rest. But mysteriously, the person who shot this video ends the video before the flywheel begins slowing down. Flywheels are used in all types of motors and other systems. If you look in your car has a flywheel. It uses it to dampen the motion of the crankshaft. They're even used on our electric grid to help even out the flow of electricity. In recent years, they've been using large flywheels with generators on them to help smooth out the power from the electric grid. The giant flywheel acts like a capacitor. I know this sucks and a lot of people aren't going to listen to me, but you really need to learn the laws of physics and read up on electronics, mechanics, and all kinds of other engineering. It's a really important part of being an inventor. Flywheels have been used for centuries, and this free energy device is nothing more than a flywheel and a motor. It's a scam just like every other free energy device here on YouTube.